house for Rosario de la Rosa and those are his ashes in that marble urn. I don't have appropriate things going on or dirty talk neither. When I think of men, I think about my husband. My husband is a Sicilian. We had love together every night of the week. We never skipped one. From the night he was married to the night he was killed in his fruit truck on that road there. And maybe that is the reason why I'm not mind crazy and don't like to talk of women that are. But I am interested now in the happiness of my daughter, who's graduating this morning out of high school. And now I'm going to be late. The band is playing and I've lost her wristwatch, her graduation present. Go on! Go on to New Orleans, you two man crazy things, you. And pick up a man on Canal Street. But not in my house, at my window, in front of my dead husband's ashes. I'm not at all interested. I'm not interested in men getting fat and bald in soldier boy play suits, tearing the clothes of girls on Canal Street and dropping paper sacks out of hotel windows. I'm just not interested in that man crazy business. I remember my husband with a body like a young boy, and hair on his head as thick and black as mine is, and skin on him as smooth and sweet as the yellow rose petal. My folks were peasants called Panini, but he come from London, a signorina, my husband. And like I sit here, and I'm satisfied, remember, because I had the best. Not the third best, not the second best, but the first best, the only best. So now I sit here, and I'm satisfied to remember. I count up the nights I had him, one night in my arms, and I can tell you how many. Each night for 12 years, 4,380. The number of nights I had him, one night in my arms. Sometimes I didn't sleep, just had him, one night in my arms. I grieve for him, yes, my pillow at nights never dry. But I'm satisfied to remember. And I would feel cheap and degraded and unfit to live with my daughter under the roof of his blessed ashes, those ashes of a rose. If after the memory, after knowing that man, I went to some middle-aged man, not young, not full of young passion, but getting a puppet on him, losing his hair and spending on sweat and liquor, and trying to fool myself that that was lovemaking. I know what lovemaking was, and I'm satisfied to remember. Go on, you do it! You go on the streets and let them drop their sacks of dirty water on you. I'm satisfied to remember the love of a man that was mine, only mine. Never touched by the hand of nobody. Nobody but me, just